Game warm-up, now the main event, the Islanders and the Devils. Islanders win, they're in the playoffs, they lose, Toronto is in. Let's get you set now.
Every Islander fan on the island will somehow find their way to the television.
Leafs are going to win this game. Yes, they are. Yes, they have.
They did what they had to do. Winning their final game of the season, the Toronto Maple Leafs knocked the Montreal Canadiens out of playoff contention while vaulting themselves into eighth spot in the East. Now all they can do is sit and watch. A week ago, the Islanders were out of the playoff picture, and their number one goaltender was put on the shelf for the rest of the season. But three straight wins has them in control of their own destiny. A win and they're in. Anything less, and the Leafs secure a date with the Sabres in round one.
Good afternoon, folks. Happy Easter, and welcome once again to the NHL on TSN for the last game of our regular season. James Duffy alongside Keith Jones, Bob McKenzie, and Darren Dreger. We knew that the playoff hopes of the Toronto Maple Leafs would likely come down to goaltending. We never guessed it would come down to the goaltending of Scott Clemenson, who will start today for New Jersey in replace of Martin Brodeur. So Toronto, an already nervous team, gets a little more edgier. Here's our James Cebulski with Leafs coach. Well, the Devils have won six in a row against the Islanders, but all those were with Martin Brodeur in nets. That's the Toronto side. The gentleman covering the game today for us is Brent Wallace in Jersey.
James, thanks very much. You know, the Islander fans have driven here in droves, a 45-minute drive, and they want to cheer on their team. Obviously, the biggest game of the season for the New York Islanders, a win, and they're in. And they get a chance to face Scott Clemenson, who hasn't seen a whole lot of action in the New Jersey Devils today. It is a big deal that Martin Brodeur is not playing. Scott Clemenson, will he do the job for the New Jersey Devils and just give Martin Brodeur the day off? It doesn't mean that much to the Devils, obviously, but they do want to get their game continued on the right path since they fired Claude Julien here on Monday. Lou Lamoriello now only coaching in his third game of the season so far. The Islanders are pumped. They say they're not nervous. They just want to go in and get the job done. They've been in this mode for a few weeks now, pretty much since Rick DiPietro got hurt about 2 weeks ago. Will they get it done? Well, we're about to find out. Puck drop is just around the corner.
All right, Brett. Your starting goaltenders are brought to you by Tim Hortons Triple Chocolate Baked Goods, irresistibly chocolatey. Yes, it's Dublelewicz versus Clemenson. Who'd have thunk it? Clemenson has basically started every 2 months, one game every 2 months this season. His last start was February 25th, a 3-2 win over Washington, so he's streaking.
Huge reasons why, not all of it on the ice. His character in the room is also very, very important to how the Islanders have managed this last week of the season. And as the final game is underway, it's Brian Gionta sending it in. That egg line for New Jersey of Eliash, Gionta, and Gomez is starting out against the Islanders' Sillinger line with Smith and Hunter. And Dublelewicz makes one instant save on a high riser from Gomez. Up comes Smith into the New Jersey zone. Away from Sillinger, now to Hunter. Sillinger has it back, and he missed wide. Brendan Witt and Sean Hill, the Islander defense pair. Colin White on defense for New Jersey as the puck comes back to the blue line and is sent along the boards to Smith. Now Hunter in the corner, checked by Rafalski, who joins White as the Devils' first defense pair today. And Elias blasts one in off the leg of Sean Hill.
Both goalies would tell you, they want to get tested early. Maybe not too tough of a test, but they want to feel the puck. Dublelewicz obviously has to get rid of any nerves as the puck is rocketed out of play on the attempt to dump it. Get rid of any nerves, and then Scott Clemenson, well, just the fact of the matter is he hasn't faced a lot of shots this season during game situations. You can practice and practice, but until you get into a game like this, you know what? Practice is a whole heck of a lot different. The kid can make a difference, though. How about that? Doesn't play an awful lot, but he can make a huge impact on the NHL season with one performance.
Darren Quint and Chris Campoli, the Islander defense pair, with Robitaille, Asham, and Blake up front. The Devils have Travis Zajac, number 19, bringing it in here with Langenbrunner, 15, and Zach Parise, number 9. Langenbrunner hustles into the corner. He's checked there by Randy Robitaille and Asham. Outlets to Blake. Jason Blake, a 40-goal scorer, into the New Jersey zone to Campoli. Quick shot and the save by Clemenson. Devils in transition. Tough time for Parise, though, getting clear of Campoli. And Chris, the Toronto native, has it back behind the Islander net. Campoli and the Maple Leafs, Carlo Koliakovo, are very, very good friends. They played a few years of junior together. One of them is going home for the summer after the events of this afternoon. Pandolfo with a steal, Madden with a shot, and that went wide. The Islanders' line now is Yashin with Kozlov and Chatan. Marc-Andre Bergeron, number 47, plays it in the trapezoid.
Nowhere is the first goal more important than in this series. All seven games this year, the team that scored the first goal has gone on to win the game.
New Jersey won five of those prior seven, none of which matter now. It's Kozlov playing it off the leg of Madden. Madden, Pandolfo, and Breland for the Devils. Madden shot blocked by Bergeron. Campoli working behind with Bergeron to regain possession and send Chatan up the right wing. Now to Smith. In over the line. Ryan Smith towards the slot. Chatan got it back. Hit the side of the net. Pandolfo chips it away. Quick centering feed deflected, held by Quint. That goes off a New Jersey stick. Along to Dowd. And icing possible here. Campoli with a step on Dowd, touches up, and they'll bring it back into the New Jersey zone. Well, Ted Nolan, admittedly nervous before the game today. His leg was rather furiously tapping during our pregame interview, and he delivers the infinity quote.
Says I, oh, sorry.
Well, just that it may be semantic, controlled, and desperate, but he's the guy that wanted desperation all along.
Well, you need that. There's that fine line between that. But when a team, you know, we talked about simplifying the game. When the Islanders do that, that's when they're most effective. I think that's probably what he's referring to more than anything.
Lukowicz and Matvichuk. Richard Matvichuk, who spent virtually all season on injured reserve, on defense now. The puck to the slot, save made, and Pody fans. Sillinger got the shot off. Clemenson got a stick on it, but then Pody missed. Erik Rasmussen, number 10, lugs it to center. Keeps going down the left wing. Rasmussen to the net. He shot it wide, and the carom comes all the way to the blue line. Rafalski pulls up and puts it into the corner where Dowd goes to work, trying to lose Bergeron. Rafalski across to White. Let's one go. That missed by a healthy margin. And Ryan Smith chips it back towards Sillinger, and the Islanders get out. Smith keeps the rush alive. Looking for Hunter. Nothing doing there. Rafalski batted it away.
In this game, if you're the Islanders, beware of the Devils' fourth liners. There's a good chance they'll get more ice time than normal, Howie, because Lou Lamoriello and his coaching staff, not a whole heck of a lot to lose in this game. Get those guys a little bit more ice time, and believe you me, as the whistle blows, the puck almost going off the ice, or actually going off the ice. Believe you me, they are excited to be able to get more ice time. Scott Clemenson excited as well to be in this game. Gets into it right away with a nice point-blank save from the slot area. And then the carom, the rebound is caromed over to his right where the puck just hopped over Tom Pody's stick. Pody continues to shine, picking up another point yesterday. Now points, 20 points in his last 21 games.
How's that for rare footage? Brodeur on the bench and Clemenson in the crease. Paul Martin on defense. Down low, Gomez, a save by Dublelewicz, who lost sight of it in the immediate aftermath. Johnny Oduya fires. That's knocked aside in front by Hill. And how much can you say about Hill and Witt this last week in particular? Robitaille floated it through the goal mouth. Blocking shots, giving up their bodies. Gomez in over the line to Gianta. He fires and he clipped the side of the net. Eliash hemmed in by Blake. Islanders try to clear. Blake double-teamed even as Gomez went down, but it's Blake sneaking away. And now Brendan Witt, who's wearing the look of 81 prior games all over his body. Shiners, bruises, bumps. Consistent with how you would expect him to look, but it almost takes on a different meaning when you consider what's happened just over this last week.
And imagine how many more bruises you would see if you didn't have all the tattoos.
It's calculated.
Yeah, that's right.
Madden sends it in. Camouflage. Pandolfo waiting in the corner. Pandolfo checked by Quint. Darren Quint, who's only been up here a little over a week, tied up by Pandolfo. And Breland works it back to the blue line. Rafalski played it towards the slot as Yashin went down to try and get in the way. Now Pandolfo checked in the corner by Campoli. And Rafalski throws it back ahead. Madden brings it in. Madden going wide on Quint, takes the shot, and Dublelewicz steers it aside easily. Campoli banks one up looking for Chetan. That didn't reach him. We've played just about 6 minutes in the opening period. And Zajac fires one that leaves the playing surface. Exactly 6 minutes in as Lou Lamoriello has done it again. He relieved this time Claude Julien of his coaching responsibilities earlier in the week, and the GM is going to coach the team through the playoffs.
And their first game right after he took over as coach, the team had a heck of a lot of jump. Real lot of jump, attention to detail, great. Then they go in and play Philadelphia the other night, and they didn't have as much energy, as much jam in that game. But there's no doubt about it, he raises the antenna of everybody on that bench a bit.
Zach Parise fires, and that's knocked aside. Deflects out of play. 6:12 gone, opening period in New Jersey.
Talked to about so much in the last few weeks. It's about his presence, and guarantee he was one of the guys that was standing up in the locker room before this game saying, fellas, just treat it like another game. You know, we've all been in these type of tough situations before. This is exciting. This is what you play hockey for. We have a chance, and that's all we've ever wanted. Have a chance. Now let's take advantage of it.
Those of you watching on TSN in Canada know all about the guy they have called Captain Canada over the years for all of the international play that he's been so involved in on behalf of Canada. Now the question is, will he continue as an Islander after this game? Depending, of course, on the outcome, as he is an unsigned, unrestricted free agent at the end of the year. But Ryan Smith has meant so much to this team just over the month and change that he's been here.
Think about all the changes that have happened to this team. Wade Dublowitz, obviously in net the last few games for the Islanders. You have Ryan Smith, Marc-Andre Bergeron. And at first, even though they seemed all like great stuff, and they were great moves, it all didn't work right away. But this team found a way, and that is what an 82-game season is about. It's finding a way through games one through game 82.
Hunter up to Smith. Ryan Smith surrounded by three Devils. Still goes to work now on the forecheck, but it's Martin wheeling it around for Gianta. He's hit by Hunter. Good job by Hunter. And Ryan Smith up on this line with Sillinger and Hunter really gives it a different dimension. Andy Hilbert worked his tail off when he was up there, but Smith is a better offensive player.
Well, no, and a lot of people were speculating that that would eventually be the move that Ted Nolan made, but remember, it didn't happen until Hilbert got hurt with the shoulder injury. Hilbert really could only play about 5-7 minutes a game because of that shoulder injury, but he's still skating very hard.
Gianta turns it back ahead. And into the Islanders' zone, Witt has Eliash bearing down on him. Witt absorbs the contact. Smith goes in for the puck. Now for Robitaille as the Islanders begin a change. Blake on right wing. Jason Blake pulls up on Matt Tkachuk, moves to the slot. Blake shoots, and a save by Clemenson as Blake got into good shooting position.
Well, the big goaltender who played his college hockey at Boston College doesn't flinch whatsoever. He doesn't move. Watch as Jason Blake's going to get the puck and go laterally. He's going to hold his ground. Clemenson's going to just stand there. Matt Tkachuk action. Boy, you can tell a D-man who hasn't played all year kind of stumbles as he's trying to pivot over to his right. And Blake gets a whole heck of a lot of room in that low slot area. But Clemenson holds his ground, makes a nice body save.
Robitaille, Asherman, Blake, the Islander line against the Zajac, Parise.
Lamoriello's elected to put John Madden line, his checking line, against Yashin, Kozlov, and Chetan the first three shifts of this game.
And from the draw, Wangenbrenner didn't reach that, trying to get his stick on the shot. And now Blake has it back for Pony. And across to Bergeron. Fires one. Big carom comes to Blake, and he got it to the stick of Clemenson. And now Wangenbrenner hustles ahead. Looking for Zajac, didn't reach him. Asham intercepts. Asham into the New Jersey zone. Thought about a shot, now gets it to the slot. In front, Blake. But Clemenson was there. Blake, two good chances now, and Clemenson has stopped them both.
He looks sharp, and you know what? He looks confident in his moves. He doesn't have a lot of extra movement at all, not a lot of space.
Jason Blake to the blue line, but Pony couldn't hold it in the zone with 11:50 to go in the opening period. Shots are 5-2 Islanders. And if the first 5 or 10 minutes of this game were going to be instructive as to the demeanor of the Islanders and however nervous they might be, they appear to be fine on that level. It doesn't appear to be an issue.
No, they're not trying to do too much. That's when the Islanders get in trouble. They seem pretty confident.
Madden trying to eliminate an icing. He does. It goes all the way through the slot and could not be caught up to by Breland. And so the Devils back in their own zone now with Rafalski sending Breland on his way. Into the Islanders zone, trying to get through. Campoli was back there to break it up. Madden waits in the corner. But it's Kozlov leading the Islanders out of their own zone. Good feed to Chatan. In over the line. He fires, and it went wide. Yashin waits for the carom to come to him. He was checked by Breland. Yashin down. Rafalski reverses. And White and Pandolfo must work it in the New Jersey zone. Now the Devils and the Islanders begin to change. 10:41 to go in the opening period. Nothing else matters. There are other games today. They're irrelevant as far as the Islanders are concerned. Quick turnaround to Smith. A drop pass broken up by Rasmussen. And Bergeron waits for it to get through the legs of the linesman.
Any question if the Devils were going to come out hard have been answered. You've had Madden nullifying and icing. You've had Rasmussen back checking hard. You've had a few attempted good shots on net. The Devils are taking this one seriously.
Well, they've taken the body unofficially. Six of the first seven hits have been recorded by the Devils. And icing called against New York.
Look, it's just ingrained in their mentality. I mean, Lou Lamoriello on down, you know, his assistants now, you know, John McClain, they're all Devils. I mean, it's Devil hockey. Lou Lamoriello wants win 50. You know, they have the record of 49. They'd like to get it back. They'd like to get it up to 50. And the Islanders keep pressing and getting the intensity on Clementson. A little fake shot by Asham actually turns into a great opportunity for Jason Blake. But again, the lateral movement of Clementson has been impressive.
And a second consecutive icing. So the Islanders can't go anywhere, but we're just going to step out briefly. 9:57 left in the first.
Go back to his demeanor, and it's just, you know, he's talking to himself during the break here. Absolutely no big deal. Chewing a little gum, having some fun in there. This kid is what it's all about. Flourishing when you get the opportunity. It's an amazing story.
He said before the game, I just want to enjoy the ride. He's taken the Islander fans on quite a ride this last week as that puck goes offside. Well, the headline has been written, Easter Miracle. Now all the Islanders have to do is provide the body of the story. Ryan Smith is one of the characters who joined the plot rather late. Most of the others have been here for the entire ride, and it's been a roller coaster over this last month.
Yeah, it's been a roller coaster a lot of this year. I mean, the last month has been an intense roller coaster. Lost my lunch a few times, probably. You can't imagine how the coaching staff feels, but overall this year, it's been a lot of ups and downs. But, it, you know, everybody said 14th, 15th place in the Eastern Conference. This team has proved a lot of so-called experts wrong.
I thought it was great that Ted Nolan admitted before the game, point blank, when I said, are you nervous? He says, yeah, I'm nervous. He says, you don't want to show it, but you have to feel it. Jason Blake looks for the trailer. It's Witt. Brendan Witt puts it down, gets the shot off. It goes wide. And Gianta hooks up with Elias. Elias with Gomez. Campoli reaches, has help from the back-checking Blake. And Campoli got it ahead, but Langenbrunner made a good play. And that allows Lukowicz to feed Rafalski. Islanders get their change in. Rafalski's cross-corner dump is covered behind the net by Darren Quinn. Long feed off the stick of Yashin. Yashin keeps going. He's got Rafalski with him. Yashin got there first. Feeds Quint. It's blocked. Quint's got to hustle back. One defender back. It's Bergeron. Breland put it behind Pandolfo. Big break for the Islanders. Two Devils back as it's brought in by Kozlov. Kozlov from a sharp angle. This is the net. That curls around to the near side. Breland trying to squeeze through the check of Chatan. And the Islanders have it back again. And now Bergeron gets the red line and the dump in, which flies into the mitt of Clementson and will provide for an offensive zone faceoff for New York.
Well, a mistake almost cost the Islanders. Ted Nolan looking on, seeing the Islanders give up a potential 3-on-2. But getting back to the point you made, Howie, about how Ted admitted his nervousness before the game, part of Ted Nolan's appeal as a person, as a coach, is his candidness. It shows the human side to him. And from day one this season, when we were back in Yarmouth, Nova Scotia, he talked about how he is a people person, how he's a nurturer, and that's how he gets the most out of his players. He's no phony whatsoever. He's the real deal.
And that's exactly what the players have said they appreciate most. Bergeron fires it in front. It's loose. They pound away. Park with a shot block. Rebound. Score! Richard Park! It's Long Island South here in East Rutherford. 1-0 Islanders.
second hard-working goal in 2 days for Richard Park. He starts it by winning the faceoff, and then his ability to get to the front of the net, battle it out. Andy Hilbert taking two red sweater Devils. Look at the effort by those three guys down low, and Richard Park gets it. Left side doorstep, he's going to just rifle it over the right pad of Scott Clemenson. He's going to battle it, just like yesterday against the Philadelphia Flyers. The Islanders up 1-0.
Huge to get the first one against a team that's playing a meaningless game. Not to discount what the Devils are going to do over the last 47 minutes and change. But boy, did the Islanders need that first one for a variety of reasons, and Richard Park has gotten it. A steal by Langenbrenner, but it's re-stolen by Sillinger. And Zajac for the Devils pushes it in. Now Pody backs up. He and Campoli are the defense pair here. And it's Hunter getting to the red line, squeezed by Martin as he sends it in. Tambellini and Bergeron assist at 11:53, the Islanders' fourth line.
Second game in a row coming through the fourth line with a good hard shift culminating in a goal from in front of the net.
Devils keep it alive. Langenbrenner down low, but Zajac had it deflected away. Zajac gets it again. Feeds the slot. Langenbrenner had it go off of Dublelewicz after someone else had made a block, but the Islanders going to get a penalty here. New Jersey will have the first power play in the afternoon.
Devils try to take away all the energy and momentum in favor of the New York Islanders. Off the faceoff, Park is going to be in front. This is going to be the guy that's going to go to the front of the net, and all he's going to do is just battle it out. He's going to out-muscle Lukowicz for enough ground right there to be able to get back at it. Then the penalty, seconds later, off the cycle, the puck to the front of the net, the quick shot, out just wide. Zajac takes the puck behind, and then in front of the net is where it happened.
And so, the Devils' power play with Hill in the box for interference will go to work. They're 14th ranked in the league. The Islander penalty killers are 19th. Devils are 4-for-29 this year on the power play against the Islanders. But Park doing more good work there on the penalty kill. He's up front with Hilbert. Witt and Pody back. And the Devils are trapped in their own zone for now. Scott Gomez. Just a little time recently with an injury, which was his second of the year. Giunta was out for a long spell, but he's out there too now. And it's cleared by Hilbert. So Maytag Clemenson puts the stick on it for Rafalski. Only the fourth start of the year for Scott Clemenson. Break up at the line, and Pody knocks it out. Down to a minute seven on the New Jersey power play. And now they've got Breelin, Parisi. Gomez will go off. Zajac hops on to replace him. Martin carries the mail. Has it poked away neatly by Chatan. That flushes the Devils out of the Islander zone. Parisi speeds ahead. Breelin actually got a fistful of Pody as Pody was trying to smack that puck out.
A little size advantage there. Swatted the ball away, so to speak.
Now it's Breelin feeding down the boards to the defenseman Martin. Zajac draped by Smith. Feeds the blue line. Johnny Oduya down the board. Zajac lines it up. Smith gets a piece of the crossing pass. And Dick Karam's out of the zone. 17 seconds left on the Devil power play. Parisi accepts the pass at the line. Sillinger works hard, doesn't get it. Martin shot tip way up high and out of play. And only 3 seconds remain to the power play.
Yeah, it was a good idea by Breelin, but he was almost too far high in the slot area to do that redirection. He ramped it, and the puck went way out of play. Martin trying to just get something through to the net as the Devils have been unable to solve the high pressure from the New York Islanders. As we get another good look at Richard Park, a guy who has managed to play every game this year for the Islanders, despite at times playing with severe bruises, broken toes after blocking shots up from the likes of Zdeno Chara.
First time this year he has scored goals in two straight games. Penalty is over. Jay Pandolfo with a wrist shot, steered away by Dublelewicz. So no shots on the power play for the Devils. That was only their third of the period, which has 4:48 remaining. Blake in on the forecheck against Colin White. And now Madden. It was deflected away by Asham, and the Islanders are doing a lot of that. Their forwards are getting back. They're getting sticks and skates on New Jersey passes. But now the Islanders have iced it. 4:27 remaining. First period. Good start for the Islanders.
Closing the stores to the New Jersey Devils as they get set to move to their new location, Prudential Center in Newark. Saw it yesterday, in fact. Looking like it's getting closer to being done.
This is the last regular season hockey game in the history of this building. The Devils know that there will be more games to come here. The Islanders want to get to that same spot. 4:14 remaining in the first period. Jason Blake drives one into the glove of Clemenson. And Pandolfo whips it up the right wing. Breland sends it in. Madden goes after Witt. Yashin waits along the board. Two Devils conspire to steal that puck from Yashin. But Breland couldn't tee it up, and Hill flings it out, only to see Rafalski drive it back in. 8-3 Islanders in shots. They have looked calm. They have not allowed odd man rushes. They have a good burst here of their own. Chatan looking for Kozlov. Pandolfo went right to him. Kozlov trying to wheel away from Martin. Hooks up with Yashin, whose centering feed went beyond the reach of Chatan. Gianta tries to bat it in, but Pody wouldn't let him. And now Chatan is back in the New York zone. Tom Pody, a very underrated, important part of this Islanders season. And that play goes offside. I don't think you can minimize his impact, and the Devils know what they miss when Eliash has been out over the years.
He has just one assist in his last four games, but Eliash is still one of the real reasons that this team has been so successful. He's one of the reasons that they have all these Stanley Cup banners here. But getting back to your Tom Pody reference as well, you know what? He has been, he's been a rock, and he's a free agent at the end of this year, just signed a one-year deal. I'm sure he'll attract a lot of attention, but fans on Long Island have embraced him, Howie. He has been marvelous. I said earlier in the first period, now 20 points on 2 goals, 18 assists in his last 21 games.
I think most of that which you hear behind me is let's go Islanders, more so than let's go Devils. Of course, the Devils fans really don't feel a whole lot of emotion towards this game. You wouldn't think. Gianta with a high riser that's wide. And the Islander fans are out here in big numbers and strong lungs.
There were a few hundred just standing right around the Islanders walkway getting out. They were chanting in the pregame the whole time.
That's just because they wanted to watch Deb Kaufman work.
Well, they're only human. They were chanting so loud, Deb had to ask them to pipe it down just a little bit, bring it down a notch or two. Islander fans, you know, look, they've had a lot to cheer about this year, as we said earlier. There wasn't that much expected from this team, except probably from, well, Garth Snow and everybody on down in the Islander organization. The fans have responded well.
Clemenson with a stop as Blake just swept it from the boards. Blake, Robitaille, and Asham, the Islander forwards. Zajac to Robitaille. He got knocked down. Matvichuk steps into Blake. Blake spins it back to Bergeron with a hard feed that Pody grabs. Lukowicz finished hard on Jason Blake. Robitaille keeps working. So does Langenbrunner. And Langenbrunner starts a two-on-two for New Jersey with Parisi. Langenbrunner back to Parisi, who got knocked down. Play continues. Devils just trying to keep it in here. They can't. And it's Langenbrunner now forced back in center. Minute 38 to go in the opening period. 9-3 Islanders in shots. 1-0 New York on the board. And a penalty coming up here against New Jersey. A delayed call. The Islanders going to get a power play. Dublelewicz goes to the bench, but he doesn't even get there before the Devils take possession. So the Islanders, with a minute 23 to play with in this first period, will have the lead as well as the man advantage.
Call made by referee Dan O'Rourke. He's working tonight along with Paul Dvorsky. Catches Zach Parise. It was in the high slot area in the offensive zone as the Devils were just trying to push the puck in, get a little change, get everybody fresh out there. Instead, he got his stick up a bit high. I thought at first it was going to be a high stick. It ends up being a slash called. The Islanders get their power play opportunity here. Lou Lamoriello can't love the fact that his team only has three shots on goal. I'm sure he'll let them know about that during the intermission. But they have come out and skated hard. And they have done that, that's for sure.
Islanders 4-for-21 on the power play this year against New Jersey, slashing against Parisi at 18:37. It'll carry into the second unless the Islanders do some business here. Hunter with Sillinger and Smith are up front. Cody and Berger on the point men. White comes in hard. Puck stays behind the net. Ryan Smith digs it loose for Bergeron. They'll put it right back behind the Devils' goal. White steps in front of Smith as we reach the final minute of the period. And the Islanders now will need 200 feet. This is Pote. A dump in by Sillinger. You don't do that as often when Martin Brodeur is the goaltender. Clemenson handled it well, though. And now Martin finds an opening. I asked Ted Nolan before the game, is there a technical change that you make in terms of your dump-ins because it's Clemenson and not Brodeur? And he says he doesn't really want them to focus and worry too much on that stuff. Sure, he always wants to keep it away from Brodeur. And that's why Clemenson didn't play that cleanly. Bergeron holds it in. Zajac to the corner. 12 to go in the period. Three Islanders on two Devils. And finally, it's Martin just pushing it down ice, and that'll end the first period. And the Islanders, I think, got everything they wanted, Billy, out of that period. Their legs seemed strong rather than wobbly. Their defensive presence, especially by...
All right, James Duffy back in the NHL and TSN studio. Just ahead, the most forgotten goaltender in hockey becomes the most talked about for one day anyway. The panel assesses Scott Clemenson's play. He is not, and it's a 1-0 Islander lead through one period of play. 40 minutes to go. We'll take you to the second right after this. And here's your recap of the first period matchup here. Islanders put the heat right on Scott Clemenson, Jason Blake. The Devils playing a little all-star game defense right there. Clemenson makes a save, though. Then Aaron Asham to Blake. And once again, Clemenson is there, but the Islanders will finally solve him here.
Bergeron fires it in front. It's loose. They pound away. Park with a shot block. Rebound. Score! Richard Park!
A little more desire from the Islanders in there, banging away, and thus a 1-0 lead on Park's 9th of the season.
Hunter, so these guys that have been the catalyst offensively the last two games for this team, as Marty Brodeur looks on and probably wonders, what would I do if I was out there right now against those guys?
How do you think this is going over? Certainly around Toronto, but in parts elsewhere, with Brodeur sitting out the last game, one that the Islanders need to make the playoffs.
Uh-huh. How about the resounding boo, I'm sure, that just came from bars and living rooms across Canada watching him right there on the screen.
Well, Clemenson stopped 8 out of 9. The power play underway with Hunter, Smith, and Sillinger, along with Bergeron and Pote. White and Lukowicz are back. Pandolfo and Madden up front for the Devils, and it's Madden on that flubbed feed from Sillinger. A crisscross with Pandolfo, and he shovels it in. And really, the only real message can be, particularly to fans of the Toronto Maple Leafs, you had your chance against the Islanders earlier in the week, and the Leafs were terribly dispassionate for a game that meant so much. Aaron Quint has it knocked aside. And now Langenbrunner waits for a help. Across to Zajac. The penalty is over. The team's at full strength. Parisi shot pinballs. Langenbrunner denied by Dublelewicz.
I'm not sure if Dublelewicz knew where that shot was going, but because he was in such good position, he got the right skate on it.
Langenbrunner fires, and Dublelewicz grabs that one. Aaron Quint up the boards. Parisi got a piece of it. And then it rolls deep into the New Jersey zone.
Howie, Quint's going to have to be stronger with his decision-making when he gets the puck. He's got to make sure he's going to be out there in a limited role, just get it at least into the neutral zone. Two times in this game, he's given it up in his own zone.
Eliash facing in the corner where Bergeron steps into him. Matvichuk across to Lukowicz. And now Bergeron pressured again by Gomez. it's been noticeable over the last five or six games how much more attention the opposition pays to Marc-Andre Bergeron as Clemenson grabs that. Bergeron's got the puck. They go right at him.
New York Islanders give up an opportunity. After killing off the penalty, the Devils get the puck in the offensive zone. Zajac's going to turn and just put the puck back up, and then it just pinballs back over to Langenbrenner, who spins and shoots. He's going to get the puck coming in the slot right there, and Dublelewicz gets a nice right skate on it.
A little more than 2 minutes gone here in the second. Brendan Witt now for Kozlov. And Rafalski goes back to get it with Kozlov, angling him into the boards. Rafalski didn't get it far enough up, so it's Kozlov joined by Chatan on the forecheck. Two against two. Kozlov trying to power away. Kozlov again looks to feed the slot. That's cluttered with red jerseys. Madden over the line. And that deflects out of play as Brendan Witt, who made the block, exchanges pleasantries with Madden.
Wade Dublelewicz, an American Hockey League All-Star, gets a chance to shine here at the National Hockey League level. Played his college hockey at Denver. Didn't win a national championship there. The Pioneers won it consecutive years after he was there, but he's been in big games before throughout his career. And the fact that he is so easygoing has helped calm his teammates down as well.
The Islanders with that fourth line on, which combined for the only goal so far. That's Park with Hilbert and Tambellini. And the puck drawn back to center, and Matvichuk races after it. In Richard Matvichuk's prime, he was one of the premier shot-blocking defensemen in the National Hockey League, and the Devils will welcome his presence back. Matvichuk works it ahead for Dowd. Dowd, Rupp, and Rasmussen for the Devils. Kept in by Lukowicz after a big hit, a big save by Dublelewicz. It's loose, and Doobie's got it. Rasmussen and first Campoli shove, and then Rupp got involved, and so did Dowd, and Richard Park for the Islanders.
Well, it was the Park line that got things going for the Islanders, and how about the Dowd line, the fourth line, for the Devils trying to get things going. Initiating a big hit is Big Mike Rupp. Shot comes from the point, but how about the right pad again of Wade Dublelewicz, and the puck just deadens after he makes the save. That hit initiates a good forecheck, and then the shot from the point, Dublelewicz makes the save. Andy Hilbert has it hit him. Wade Dublelewicz covers it up again, but the fourth line for New Jersey was very key in their victory in Philadelphia, as well as Jim Dowd scored a shorthanded goal against the Flyers that eventually was the game-winning goal.
Devils have three shots in this period, which is 3:13 old. That's as many as they had the entire first period. Their season's low. Parisi, a shot that went wide. Zajac the rebound, got it to the slot, eaten up by Smith. And out comes Hunter. Fred Hunter pushed it ahead so Smith can get after it. Hunter does too. But Martin withstood the pressure. Johnny Oduya, number 29 on defense for the Devils. Cody hard around. Zajac couldn't hold it, and that allows Smith to hook up with Sillinger. Swept away from Hunter by Oduya. Zajac drops for Parisi. A cross intended for Langenbrenner. Hunter and Cody were there to break it up. Smith down the board. Rafalski sufficiently slowed him. Boy, have the Devils struck gold over the years with Madden and Rafalski, undrafted free agents who have been a big part of championship teams here. Long lead for Asham batted away. Rafalski watches Asham before scooting in front of him to win the puck. But it didn't clear. Hill kept it in, but now Rafalski brings it out. Up for Eliash. Patrick Eliash pulls up to the slot. He shoots. It's deflected. Eliash gets it back. Dublelewicz down. It comes in front, but Gomez steered it wide. However, a whistle, and the trail referee, Dan O'Rourke, has an interference penalty.
Against New Jersey, I believe, for crashing to the front of the net. I think it's goaltender interference on Gianta. He hasn't skated over. Yes, now he does. The Devils, though, have come out playing much more aggressive, especially the third guy.
Eliash pulls up. Now Gianta ends up bumping into Dublelewicz. He was saying that he got bumped by Robitaille on the back check. Here's a nice ISO on Gianta as he's just going to be the third guy. Then he's going to go hard to the net. He says he gets bumped into Wade Dublelewicz by Robitaille. Doesn't look like much of a bump there, but it was the back referee making the call. Islanders dodge a bullet and go on the power play again.
Interference at 4:40, second Islander power play. They were 0-for-1 without a shot on their first, which bridged the end of the first and beginning of the second period. But here's Blake firing. He missed the net. Hard around to Chatan. Now Miro along the boards to Bergeron. He and Pody have the points. Yash and Blake, Chatan the forwards. Blake with room, pushes one on goal. Clements in the save. It's loose. Pody in to take a shot that's knocked away. Pody gets it back. Now Pody goes to the corner. Wheels it around to Bergeron, looking for room. Finds Chatan. Bergeron straight away. A shot, or more of a pass, really intended for the blade of Blake. Deflected off the glass, held in by Bergeron. Blake hit hard by White. Referee took a tumble, too, in an unrelated event. It's Pody shooting one that Pandolfo got a piece of. Pandolfo pressuring. Pody kept it into Yashin. His shot deflects off the glass. Two Islanders on Martin, who got it to the boards. Madden took the hit from Yashin. Puck only goes as far as the line before it's played out by Pody. And that'll bring the faceoff outside the New Jersey zone.
Early in this season, we saw the Islanders' power play very active with the fourth man, the D-man, coming down the weak side. Now the Islanders are keeping more of an umbrella formation, and they're collapsing to the front of the net, or they're doing a timing play as we watch some action in front of the net transpire. They do a timing play with Jason Blake kind of cutting through the mid-low slot area where Tom Pody kind of just punches the puck through to the net. They are almost able to make that work again here. They did it twice yesterday with good effectiveness.
Braylon knocked Campoli down, but Kozlov has it back. 40 seconds left on the Islander power play. Kozlov, Smith, and Hunter now up front. They turn it over, or Oduya clears. And Dublelewicz leaves it for Campoli. He and Quint play the points. Kozlov around. Clemmingson cut it off. Little hesitation there. And that allows Smith to keep it deep. 12 to the power play. There's where Brodeur being on the bench makes a bit of a difference. Smith for Kozlov. And now Quint walks the line, has a shot deflect out of play just as the penalty expires.
Well, definitely more than a little hesitation as Clemmingson has the puck behind the net and he doesn't make a decision with it. So Ted Nolan makes sure to get the guys on him and the Islanders get a little bit more power play time.
Well, Darren Quint got a call, at least his agent Mike Liute did, a little over a week ago. You know who called Ted Nolan this morning? Pat LaFontaine, who, of course, played for Ted in Buffalo and scored that epic goal that we have shown you a couple of times, 20 Easters ago, this Sunday, today, to win that playoff series. Low bridge on the Islander bench. 13:05 remaining, second period. They're all right.
Sorry.
That area, that's why the guys are punching or trying to punch the puck through to the net a bit more, but they're going to need Yashin to shoot more. First period, Howie, no shots officially. They need him to use that big shot of it to be effective.
Devils have their egg line on right now against the Islanders' Sillinger line. Eliash with a shot that's stopped by Dublelewicz. White works it across. Rafalski put it off Gomez's stick. And the Devils forced back in their own zone with 12:39 to go in the second period. Shots are 11-6 Islanders. They have held New Jersey to six shots through 2:32, shy of half a game. Again, Clemmingson having trouble handling the puck. So Smith is able to take advantage. Gomez and Smith together.
Beg your pardon, Howie. That's game versus practice situation right there. You cannot simulate a game with your goalie communication with your D-man.
Eliash down the boards. Hill is with him. Hill gets a shower, but Eliash lost the puck. Brendan Witt put it off of Gomez. Eliash trying to keep it in the zone. He did. As Gomez played it back to the blue line, nobody was there. Smith goes right at the puck carrier, Lukowicz. But not get it ahead of the breaking Zajac. It stays in again, though, and now Parisi fires. A pad save by Dublelewicz. He came way out, too. Lukowicz, a shot went wide. Parisi was knocked down in the slot, wants a penalty that doesn't come. And Hunter steers it in. Lukowicz to Matvichuk. Parisi for Zajac now. Robitaille got back to break it up. The defensive play by Mike, or at least Randy Robitaille, if you're watching in Buffalo. Now it's just a subtle way of saying hi to Mike Robitaille. Now Asham across Robitaille. Oh, a good play by Matvichuk, because they had a player all alone in front of Clemenson. And now it's Blake. Matvichuk blocks shots. That was a little bit different, but just as crucial for New Jersey. Campoli hustles back into his own zone. Ahead for Blake. Now the dump in, and the Islanders will change. Matvichuk. But softly by Yashin. That bounces over Bergeron's stick. Dowd applies some pressure. Stays on him. Rupp's there too. Three Devils ended up going to Bergeron. There's going to be a penalty to the Devils here. Kozlov fires. It's deflected into the corner. Delayed penalty as Matvichuk touches up. The Islanders are going to have the man advantage.
Hard work along the wall there. Jimmy Dowd was battling with Bergeron there, and it ended up being two other Devils that collapsed on him. Earlier it was a chance as Parise shoots and Dwight Dublowitz way out of his crease. That's his most aggressive play there. He comes out hard, challenges. Pads have been very, very active. Then the other way they go as there's a delayed penalty. The little pass to the front here. This is before that actually, as Matvichuk goes down and makes a nice one-handed play. And then Jimmy Dowd coming in right there. The hook on Marc-Andre Bergeron gets his stick behind him. Marc-Andre Bergeron still keeps the puck moving forward.
Off the draw, Pony drives it into Clemenson's glove. Remember, Billy, we've talked recently about how the opposition has really made a point of pressuring Bergeron when he's had the puck. That time, three of Lou Lamoriello's Devils were around Bergeron, and it was the hook that created the power play.
But Jimmy Dowd from Brick, New Jersey, a local boy, got behind him. That's what ends up happening. So he's behind him. He gets himself in a vulnerable spot, and that's what transpires or leads to that penalty. But yeah, then the other Devils all collapsed on him, all for naught, though.
And now with the Islanders on the power play, that puck pops into center. Islanders have Chetan, Yashin, and Blake with Bergeron and Cody back. Yashin down the boards. Pandolfo going after him. Is it back to the blue line to Pony? Bergeron, one-timer, and a save by Clemenson, a good one, with Chetan right in front of him.
No space between Miro Chetan's stick blade and the body of Scott Clemenson. The big goaltender comes out, and he gets real square right next to Miro Chetan. So if Miro is going to redirect the puck, it's going to have to be perfect placement as they're going to get together right in there. You see how they're right next to each other. Miro probably, if he had the perfect situation, would have backed away about a half a foot or so to get some separation so the puck has some room to carry him in.
Hunter working the boards for Sillinger, and Bergeron, one-timer, missed the net. That's what they want to set up. That hard one-timer for Bergeron. Well, that time he didn't hit the net. Smith. And a hold off White. Look at Smith. The legs keep working. And he feeds Hunter to Pody. Hunter again. Pandolfo on him. Feeds Pody. Pressured by Madden. Smith is in front of the net. Bergeron lines it up. It hopped over Sillinger's stick. Smith still right in front. Hunter, 51 to the power play. And White doesn't clear. Hit his own man, Pandolfo. So Bergeron steers it behind the Devils' goal. Comes to the boards. Bergeron steps up. White trying to muscle it up the boards. More good play by Smith prevented it. And again, the Devils fail to clear. It's Hunter now. Madden all over Hunter. But Pody grabs it. Hard to Hunter. Smith right back in front of the net. Sillinger out of the corner. Feeds Pody. One-timer is tipped over the glass and out of play with 20 seconds remaining on the Islander power play.
A lot of offensive zone time. One bad attempt to clear by White doesn't get out. One bad break, if you're a Devils fan, over the stick of John Madden, leads to the Islanders keeping the play in the offensive zone. One of the reasons why Ted Nolan's squad have been able to get more looks from the pointman on this power play, Howie, is the fact that instead of setting it up high, meaning with either Poirier or Bergeron, they've actually set it up along the half wall or in the corner, thereby drawing the attention of the Devils to that area of the ice instead of being able to stand right next to Poirier or Bergeron when they set the play up.
12 seconds left to the power play. Oduya in the corner. Gave it up to Blake. He feeds the point to Campoli. Dowd ready to come out. Blake moves up, shoots. Clemenson the save. Blake hustles after it. Penalty is over. Blake keeping it along the boards. Eliash angles him. Blake looking for space behind the net. Breland has the puck. Trying to force it out, and he does. But Blake gets it right back. Yields it into the Devil's zone as the Islanders change. Lukowicz curls it past Eliash. So it's Hill in the Islanders' zone, across for Witt. No! That went off of Park's stick. No icing. Tambellini and Oduya get there together, but Hilbert flies in. Hilbert for the Islanders now. Again, the Islander fourth line buzzing here on the forecheck. Andy Hilbert feeds the blue line. Hill, wrist shot, rockered away by Clemenson. Park got it back, though. Taken in by Lukowicz. And then Eliash steers it the other way. Oduya looks to see who's with him and makes the safe play, dumping it all the way down. No icing call. 7:25 to go in the period. Hilbert lost it to Gomez. Giunta across. Parise missed the net. And now Asham. Got it to the far corner. Rafalski has a step. Makes a good turn to lose Asham. And Parisi to Giunta. Ryan Giunta too far for Gomez. Giunta gets it again, though. Now it's Parisi slipping it past Gomez. And the Islanders look to attack. It's Blake on right wing. Campoli joins the play after Blake took a hit from Matvichuk. Robitaille finds it behind the Devils' goal. Langenberg just fell down up at the top of the left circle. Jason Blake was with him. I don't know if they made contact, but either way, a spill by Langenbrunner as Parisi dumps it in. 6:29 remaining, second period. Islanders got a couple of power plays and have failed to connect. The only goal of the game, Richard Park. Islander fourth liner in the first period. And the tension grows even thicker north of the border. It's Yashin putting it right through the goal mouth on his second attempt after Clemenson got his pads on the first one. Chatan knocked down. And Bergeron back. The Devils have generated virtually nothing in terms of opportunities off the rush. And the Islanders have kept the front of the net pretty well clear. Devils have had just one shot on goal over the last 11 minutes. And again, you have to reiterate, the game means nothing to them and everything to the Islanders. And sure, you can be told you've got a chance to play spoiler, but it can't possibly be that big of a motivator when you know, especially with a veteran team largely, that your real season starts in a few days. Pandolfo fires. Dublelewicz confident way out of the crease to make the stop with 5:18 remaining in the second period. The Devils needed to win in Chicago to make the playoffs for the first time. And they went into overtime against the Blackhawks. John McClain scored against Darren Pang. And the Devils won, thereby knocking the Rangers out and made the playoffs for the first time, went all the way to the seventh game of the semifinal.
How about the celebration they had afterwards on that goal? You would have thought they won the seventh game of the semifinal.
You know what else is funny? Is that the first goal of the game was scored in the first period by defenseman Ken Danico. And after Danico scored, he started to go back to the New Jersey bench. Jim Schoenfeld, who was the Devils coach at the time, is motioning, stay out there. Danico says to him, no, you got to get me off. I'm too pumped up now. I'll hurt you. I got to get to the bench. He was there, and he's probably Mr. Devil, really,
yeah,
Ken Danico. And Scott Stevens, of course, would combine with Danico to win some Stanley Cups here, but Ken Danico, 23 at the time, was so pumped up after scoring the goal. He said, you better get me off the ice, coach, or it's going to be trouble. Richard Park said no such thing to Ted Nolan today after Park scored the first goal. At least as far as we know. Remains 1-0 Islanders. Rupp shot one through traffic that was stopped by Dublelewicz.
Oh, some of the best chances in this game for the Devils, and they haven't had a lot, but they have come from this fourth line. They're working hard.
Offside, 4:29 remaining. Second period, still 1-0.
Tapes the five-hole close and just swats the puck into the corner. Rupp has had a good hit or two in this game as well, and he almost had this game tied up. Big guy, 6'4", 225 pounds.
And originally an Islander draft pick. First-round pick, in fact. 4:24 remaining here in the second. Glad you've been with us this afternoon. Say, on Long Island, have you had to change your shirt once or twice? It's been one of those nervous afternoons with the entire season riding on the result of this one. And conversely, in Toronto, I'm sure they are just as jittery because they can now do nothing about their fate. And I'm sure Lou Lamoriello will come under some scrutiny up in Canada. But you know what? He's worried about his team just as Ted Nolan is concerned about his. And that's all that can matter.
Well, if he could see his team get another goal and a little breathing room here, that would make everybody in the Long Island area breathe a lot easier. Devils also would be forced to open it up a bit more. They're really okay with this, Howie, right now. They're playing their Devil-style hockey in the neutral zone. They're waiting for that one golden opportunity to tie it up.
Gianta along the boards, had it blocked by Witt. And Sillinger feeds Hunter. Over the line, Trent Hunter to the corner. And Clemenson steers that away. Devils look to break out here. It's Gomez moving well into the zone. Eliash was well covered by the back-checking Smith. And so Ryan Smith has it back. Sillinger, though, is stripped by Gianta. And Dublelewicz bails Sillinger out. Gomez behind the net. Smith was on Gomez as that shot rang through from Elliott. Now Smith gets it back. So Smith steals it from Patrick Eliash and leads the Islanders into the New Jersey zone before heading off on a change. They come down to 3:06 remaining in the second period. Shots are 16-11 Islanders. The Devils had only three in the first period. Devils want a change here. Now Eliash gets to the bench. Breland lugs it long enough to get Pandolfo on to complete the change as Madden goes to the forecheck. And Zajac as well, or at least Breland, pardon me. Pandolfo has it. Kozlov loses it again. Pandolfo rounded around, but Chetan was there. And Pody fires it up the left side. Flicked deep by Yashin. Oduya checks to see who's with him. There were a pair of Islanders, but Oduya made a good play to connect with Breland. Oduya thought about stepping up for that puck, but thought better of it, and Martin worked it ahead. Pandolfo lines it up along the board. Breland and Witt come together behind the Islander net. Pandolfo in to help out. He wins the puck. Tries to feed the blue line. Robitaille broke it up. Chetan into the zone. Drops it for Hill. A save by Clemenson with Robitaille skating right by, poised to make a deflection.
Sean Hill jumps up into the play as we give you another Panasonic digital replay. We're going to first show you Wade Dublelewicz saves as he gets his shoulder on that shot. The Devils, like a lot of teams, think the book on Wade Dublelewicz being only listed at 5'10 is to shoot high. And you know what? Even he would admit that's probably the book on me as well. But he's come up big because he comes out to the top of his crease, protects his head right there, and he knocks it away.
From the draw, it's Asham after Blake had been knocked down following the faceoff. Wheeling it the other way, Langenbrunner hustles to get there with a pinching Pody, who ultimately kept it in and got it to the net where Clemenson sweeps it aside. Blake has Rafalski all over. Zajac pulls up on Asham, finds Blake right in his face. Now the Devils out, but Zajac's pass didn't reach Parisi. Bergeron goes across to Pody.
That was a lazy pass. You know, the Devils, you know, maybe that's a little sign of not having it. That was a lazy pass in the neutral zone there. Usually much more crisp, much better tape to tape. Yeah.
Langenbrunner has trouble with that puck at his feet and then pounded by Sillinger as we reach the final minute of the second period. The goal came in the first from Richard Park. And that's been it so far. Hill ahead to Hunter with a little space to the slot wide. He shoots from Clements and stops it. Sillinger almost got to the rebound, but Eliash did. And he fires it ahead. Gianta with Gomez. Gianta drops it for Gomez. He's dumped by Hill. Play continues. Good work by Sean Hill.
Good play. Good. No penalty whatsoever. Not sure what these fans want called on that good defensive play.
27 left in the period. Gianta across to Gomez. Now to Lukowicz. That shot flutters in front. Dublelewicz stopped it after Eliash tried to backhand a fluttering puck with 19.9 seconds to go in the period.
Eliash very unhappy with himself, and for good reason. He feels that if he held on to this puck perhaps for a half second more, instead of just kind of swatting at it, probably would have had more time. What, right there, he just turns and swats at it. Doesn't get much on it. He knows that he has a much better look at it than this. Right there, he misses it, basically. Take that half second to corral it. He could have just got a quick shot off instead. Got nothing on it whatsoever.
From the draw, it's Bergeron getting it ahead to Chatan. Kozlov first to get it behind the double goal. Hit by Lukowicz. Chatan has it back. Chatan tries to feed it in front. 5 seconds left. Bergeron to the corner. Missed by Chatan. Kozlov looks to wheel it to the net. He hit the side of it just as the period expires. And after two periods, we're right where we were at the end of one, which means advantage Ted Nolan.
...is Mike Sillinger, who is with our Brent Wallace.
Mike, going into the third period, are you content to stay the way things are right now with the New Jersey Devils?
Well, I don't think you're never content with the Devils. You know, they play a pretty patient style. You know, they rely on you to make mistakes. And we got a one-goal lead going in the third, and we got to stay on our toes here. We got to continue to forecheck, continue to, play in their zone because, they got some firepower up front, and, they can score goals.
Any concern about losing focus with 20 minutes away from advancing to the playoffs?
Oh, we've had focus now for the last three games. You know, I think... A week ago, everyone counted us out. You know, they're paying no attention to the Islanders, and obviously, we're the biggest view game right now. So I think as far as staying focused, it's going to be pretty easy.
Just quickly, how much fun has this little while been of, coming down to every game, meaning something, going down the stretch?
Well, it's been great. You know, obviously, we had to take care of business. You know, we had four games left, and we knew we had to win them all. And, obviously, we've won three, and we got 20 minutes to go, and hopefully we can win this one, too.
Mike, thanks very much.
Thank you.
Okay, coming up. In case you missed anything, your second period recap. Early in the period, Devils searching for the equalizer.
Crazy shot, pinballs. Langenbrunner denied by Dublelewicz.
Oh, he's becoming a folk hero in Long Island. Another save here on Brad Lukowicz from the point, and then Dubé covers up. Mike Sillinger failing to clear here. Brian Gianta off Dubé's shoulder, and thus the score remains 1-0 Islanders. The Devils only with 12 shots through two periods, but that's kind of common for the Devils anyway. The Isles, one period away from playoff berth. We'll take you there now.
Time of your season, if not the last few seasons. The Islanders missed the playoffs last year. The prior year, there was the lockout. So you have to go back 3 years. Not a whole long time in the context of Stanley Cup playoff routes. Just ask them what they're feeling in Toronto, where they're 20 minutes away from 40 years without a Stanley Cup. But the Islanders have a lot of business to take care of between now and the next 45 real-time minutes or so as Clemenson stops the puck behind the Devils' goal. Hunter picks it off. Hunter starting with Sillinger and Smith. That's Oduya in, putting the body on Ryan Smith. Devils have the egg line up front. And it's Gianta throwing one at Dublelewicz. And he'll hold on, making a safe play in the first 30 seconds of the period.
You know, when you think about what assistant coach Danny Flynn said to Deb Kaufman moments ago about how if you had told us that we would be in this position after getting thumped in Phoenix, that night was just, it started out great with a goal a minute into it or so, but after that, oh my, was that an awful night there. And then that whole West Coast trip was tough until Mike Dunham came in on October 11th against Anaheim and helped settle things down with that exciting victory in Anaheim. This team would be ecstatic if you'd said that back then. But what a tough start. How far this team has come. It's pretty impressive.
Now, you mentioned Mike Dunham. Rick DiPietro carried this team most of the season. Mike Dunham made some vital contributions along the way, and now Wade Dublelewicz has done the same. And if you're wondering, if the Islanders get in, what about Rick DiPietro in the playoffs? We have no idea. It's as simple as that. We have not been given any inkling as to Rick's availability. Jason Blake goes wide and shoots one off a stick, but that's still very premature with 18:54 to go in the third period. Couple of Devils, Parisi, and Zajac took a spill, as did Randy Robitaille in center. Kozlov comes back to get the puck in the Islanders' zone. Witt and Hill, the defense pair. Madden throws it back now, and Rafalski handles it. That outlets to Madden. John Madden in the Islanders' zone, trying to get through, couldn't do it. Witt swept it to the corner. Breland hooks up with Madden, back for Breland. Backhands one that got through and was stopped by Dublelewicz. Witt away from Pandolfo, doubled out by Yashin. Chetan applying some pressure to Colin White. And now White pulls up to shake Chetan, and the Islanders will change. Rafalski for Madden into the Islanders' zone. Madden can't keep it in. And now Park takes off after him. Richard Park with the only goal of this hockey game. It came in the first period at the 11:53 mark. The Devils have been held to 12 shots. The Islanders 18, 2:20 into the third period. Michael Rupp threw it to the Islander line. Pody has it. And now Hilbert for Smith. Checked in the slot. Rasmussen the other way. Eric Rasmussen thought about a shot. Randy Robitaille took the puck away. And McFichuk put it off of Witt. Down, almost had it loose. And it's recovered, but not cleared. Lukowicz fires, and it's grabbed by the butterflying Dublelewicz.
Well, that was a good shot coming from the point, but nobody in front of the net. Screen Wade Dublelewicz. Mike Dunham, you mentioned moments ago how he made a lot of contributions throughout the year until Wade Dublelewicz took over the last few games. But don't also, you know, discount the fact what Dunham has done. Even though he's not playing, he's been very supportive of Wade Dublelewicz and his effort. And also, remember, before Dublelewicz went to Tom Pody to talk about some of the Ranger tendencies, the first guy he went to as well was Mike Dunham on the bench going into that shootout that was, you know, the key to the Islanders getting back in it. So, you know, Mike Dunham, well, yeah, he struggled a bit at the end, maybe on the ice. He's been nothing but a real champ off the ice for this team.
And now Blake takes the puck in the corner. Turning on Gomez. Blake feeds the blue line to Witt. Tried to line it up. Now he throws it through. It got to Clemmensen.
Good save.
And then Asher makes a block of an intended pass by Eliash. 3.5 gone in the third. I know it's not moving quickly enough for you if you're an Islander fan, but it's still 1-0. With the shots 19-13, New York. Meantime, north of the border, the clock can't slow down enough. It's only Toronto that still has a chance. Toronto and the Islanders. Chetan trying to put it in front. Paul Martin gave him very little. And now Pandolfo throws it to the Islander line where Cody grabs it.
How about the contrast between last night's game between Toronto and Montreal? The 11 goals scored, the craziness of it. Uh-oh. As a penalty's going to be called against the Islanders for a trip.
Cody waited as long as he could to take possession, but it'll be a New Jersey power play.
Well, you were mentioning the fans in Toronto. My point was, how about the contrast? You have that absolutely crazy game. At times, it was poor execution, so poor in that game that it became incredibly fun to watch. I mean, it was crazy as we see the penalty taken by Kozlov. And then here, you barely, I mean, you have 22 or 32 shots on goal combined right now.
You know what's ironic,
so
Billy?
Different.
If you believe in irony, think that it was Steve Bégin who took a penalty, double minor, which opened things up for Toronto on the power play. Who was it who collided with Rick DiPietro, which changed the course of the Islanders' season? Steve Bégin.
Remember we talked about hockey gods yesterday? Gods have a funny way of working.
Kozlov for a trip at 4:14. Second power play for New Jersey. They managed nary a shot on their first. Zajac, Parisi. Hooked it up by Sillinger as Parisi tried to return it to Zajac. Breland, Langenbrunner, Rafalski, the rest of the Devils' power play. Parisi got it to Langenbrunner, and now Breland behind the net. Breland bumped by Witt. Rafalski to Zajac. Parisi going wide. Zajac moves to the front of the net. Rafalski across. Langenbrunner's drive missed the net. Comes hard around. Parisi can't keep it in. Good job by Hilbert. And Parisi has it back. In comes Brillin. Trying to drop one that Pody wouldn't let, but now he does. And Rafalski shot it off of Hilbert. Halfway through the power play. Rafalski jumps in. Hilbert went to him. The puck stays in. And now Rafalski looks for a play. Across to Langenbrunner. Dublelewicz got a piece before it's cleared by Park. 40 to go. New Jersey power play. Islanders made their change quickly. Gomez works it in. Eliash goes after Bergeron. It sits in the corner. Smith working over Gomez. Now Gomez away from the referee as well as Bergeron. DeMartin. Eliash to Gionta. Get it through Bergeron's stick, and Hutter clears.
Natives getting restless here at Continental Airlines Arena. They're used to seeing the other team shut out. Marty Brodeur with 12 on the season, not seeing their own Devils get shut out.
Gomez weaving through center. Gomez tees it up. It flutters down low, and Eliash pushed it wide. Kozlov out of the box. The team's at equal strength. 13:41 to go in the third. It's the recently released Kozlov applying the pressure. And Robitaille gets it in over the line with Blake and Kozlov. Robitaille throws one wide of Clemenson. Three Islanders were trapped, the forward. So here comes Eliash the other way, looking tired. He drops it, gets it back. Eliash takes a shot. It's blocked by Hill. And the Islanders now get rid of it as Blake sends it in.
Brendan Witt might have gotten away with a penalty in front of the net, too, as he took down Gionta when that shot was released. Referee looking the other way.
Lukowicz threw it off the glass. Tan tries to muscle it out, but that was gloved down by Rupp. The play offside with 13:02 remaining in the third period.
Now, Brendan played almost 22 minutes yesterday against the Philadelphia Flyers. A solid amount of time. There was a stretch for a while where he was playing 25, 26, 27 minutes, but they were able to scale back a little bit yesterday for Brendan, get him a little extra energy for today's game, and he has come through, played almost 14 minutes so far in this game. You better expect to see him an awful lot the remaining 13 of this one.
Tom Pody flubs a pass in the corner, but Madden centering feed was batted out of the zone. Rafalski was checked by Yashin, and Rasmussen tries to wheel it around the boards, and Chetan went right to White. The Devils a little ragged trying to come out here. Good job by Kozlov. So Rafalski has to play it across with 12 and a half to go in the third period. A 1-0 lead that if the Islanders hold, will take them to the playoffs. Chetan up the right side. Madden after him. Chetan dumps Martin. Yashin steals, put it in front. It bounds away. Comes to Park. He scores! Richard Park, his second of the game.
No doubt, when the puck's on that guy's stick, he makes things happen, doesn't he? Richard Park hasn't scored a lot this year, but he's gotten huge goals this weekend. The forecheck initiated by Chetan and the wraparound by Yashin, all fine because it keeps the pressure down low. Our second look gives you our Panasonic digital replay, and it shows you a picture-perfect shot. Upper corner over the blocker for Richard Park. His second goal of the game and his second two-goal game of the season. His first.
There are pockets of Islander fans in this building standing and cheering in unison, some wearing blue Islander jerseys, others orange, and all with the same mindset right now. Jubilation, albeit early. Still 11:56 to go in the third. When you look at how unlikely the task was even a week ago, consider the players in the play this afternoon. Dublelewicz and Parr.
Penalty coming.
And now a penalty.
Yeah, it's going to be against Ryan Smith for a hold. Hey, one thing about Richard Park. I talked to him before the game.
get another look at the goal, you're going to see him get it in the high slot area, and just make no mistake about it, there is a good initiation on the forecheck. Martin taken down by Chetan. That's the reason that Yashin can get to it, and then there's the shot. But Richard Park, you know, it's cliche. You ask the guys, how you doing, how you feeling? You know, and he, you know, you've been through this before, and Richard Park looked at me and said, you know what, look, I've been in game seven. You know, he's been involved in big game seven with Minnesota, with the Wild there in the Western Conference. He said, this truly is just another good opportunity to do something in my career and another game. Really, that's the way I'm approaching it. And he has come through like a wily veteran. What a nice sign for the Islanders picking him up.
Trying to get through is Eliash. Nothing doing there. Park from Chetan and Yashin at 7:51. Richard Park, late sign by the Islanders over the summer.
Actually, in training camp, basically, yep. Right before that, a two-year deal, just a bit over the league minimum. Brought in because he's a smart player, learned a lot. He always would tell me he learned so much while playing for Minnesota and Jacques Lemaire.
He could always skate. He had always great attitude, excellent energy, but because he was such a smart hockey player as well, he could play in any situation. He has fit in magnificently here under Ted Nolan.
Centering feet, batted away by Pote. That chant you heard, which you might have imagined with the Devils on the power play, would have been, let's go Devils. I was looking around. Those were Islander fans yelling and clapping. Gomez to Eliash, stopped by Dublelewicz, and then it comes back to Eliash.
Hit him up high near the head.
Listen to who's controlling the house here. Rafalski to Langenbrunner with a drive that went way wide, and Eliash kicks it back towards Gomez. 54 to the power play for New Jersey. Gomez gets it back. Park and Pote working on him. So's Hilburn, and it can't be held by Rafalski. 43 left, Devil power play. Gomez to Eliash. He leans into it. Save Dublelewicz. It's loose. Good job by Park, that time defensively to maintain position. Eliash to Rafalski. Now to Gomez. There are bodies in front. Gomez shoots it. Got through it. Dublelewicz makes the save and gets the doobie salute from a big percentage of this crowd here in New Jersey. Back in Toronto, they're probably mumbling something else.
Wade Dublelewicz comes through, and it matters most for his team. With the power play opportunity for the Devils coming, you knew that this was a big chance for them to cut this deficit into one. That first shot catches him just to the side of the head, right shoulder area, but he sticks with it, he finds it. It's a little unorthodox, but it doesn't matter. He holds on to the rebound there. That's the key save right now. He holds on to it because Gionta and Langenbrunner were there ready to pounce on it, and then the scrum ensued afterwards as well. Confident play, though, from the kid right now.
John Hill looks for room and finds it. 19 to go, one rush remaining on this New Jersey power play with 9:53, less than half a period to go here in the third. Hey, Jack, checked by Bergeron. And Bergeron, who lost his glove, has to reach down to pick it up. Penalty's over. Team's back at full strength. Parisi behind the net. For Zajac, centering feet, pushed wide, rebound, Parisi off an Islander leg. Comes back to Martin. He fires one that's smacked away by Smith. Well, Ryan Smith has been all over all three zones in this game. He's been superb, as you would expect in a game of this magnitude. One in which he essentially played last year. Remember, Edmonton got in at their last game of the season, but after they won their game, they had to wait about an hour or so for Vancouver and San Jose to wrap up, to determine that Edmonton would go to the playoffs. And this is what all Islander fans hang their hats on. They went from the last entry, eighth in the conference, all the way to the seventh game of the Stanley Cup Final. If you're gonna dream, you might as well dream big. And there are just 8:47 to go in the third period here. Robinson shovels it away from Robitaille. Randolfo with the outlet. Rasmussen held off by Hill. Bergeron, who was part of that scramble by the Oilers last year, hurls it over to Aaron Esham. Esham, a former Canadian, so he can certainly relate to some degree to the pain that they're feeling in Montreal today. For so long, they looked as though they were a lock to be in the Stanley Cup playoffs. Now they are done. 8:07 remaining in the third. Yashin fires, blockered away by Clemenson, and got it back to the net. Eliash around the other way. That went off Gomez's glove, recovered by White. Now times are wasted. Maybe not quite fast enough for an Islander fan. Gianta put it through the slot. Of course, it's moving in double time up in Toronto. I don't know what 7:36 Canadian is, but that's how much time there is left. And now Hill plays it out of the zone. Rafalski across now to White. Batted down at the line by Witt. And it's as much a matter of holding the blue line right now and just not allowing the Devils any space. But they may have some here as Parisi moves in. Kick save, Dublelewicz. Well, there's no question who owns this house right now. It's the last regular season game ever in this building. Martin shot, got through it. Dublelewicz grabs it. He'll take the contact. 6:54 remaining in the third period.
Here's your game story brought to you by Molson Canadian. It's a Canadian game. You all know the implications. Islanders hold on to win. They will go to the playoffs. Doobie and Park, the story defensively and offensively, respectively, for the Islanders.
Actually, before Junior, to play Junior B out there and further his hockey career, about an hour and a half, 2 hours away from the Toronto area, 119 miles to be exact. He's got a lot of friends out there. His sister actually moved out there with him to help take care of him. Very important to his family. He made a lot of friends in the Toronto area. I'm not sure how many friends he has remaining in the Toronto area right now as he has both goals for the Islanders.
From the draw, Brendan Witt turns it away from Langenbrunner. Held in, Oduya's drive misses the net. And Ryan Smith now. It's away from Langenbrunner once more. 6:40 and counting. Remaining in the third. Sillinger can't get in, but he throws the puck in. Clemenson leaves it for Martin. The Islanders change on the move. Zajac. Cross corner dump in, but Bergeron covers for New York. Comes all the way around and out of the zone. And it's picked off by Asham. In over the Devils' line. Play got knocked down. Robitaille threw one at Clemenson that I don't think he saw, even though he got a leg on it.
One shot, and then everybody backs off right now. Five guys in the neutral zone. They are playing Devil-style hockey now. Take the shot, get back, clog up the neutral zone.
The playoffs are 5:56 away if the Islanders can hold a 2-0 lead. Clemenson exchanges with Matvichuk. And now Dowd. Checked in center by Chetan. Kozlov hemmed in by Matvichuk. To the blue line, Hill, and that's blocked by Ruff. Yashin tried to out-muscle Lukowicz. He does feed Chetan. He shoots. Save made by Clemenson. Rebound sits in front until it's pushed away and brought along by Ruff. Ruff wanted the red line. Didn't quite get there, and the Islanders have it back. 5:17 and counting to go. And Lukowicz leaves it behind the New Jersey goal. The Islanders are now flooding the neutral zone. Now Smith up to the goal crease to keep an eye on the puck handler Rafalski. No teammate in sight. In fact, this one will go as an icing. 4:50 to go. If you're an Islander fan, you got time for one more shirt change.
Making it a third time. The other 2 years, 1990 and 1994.
You might want to read the papers in Canada tomorrow. Montreal and Toronto would stand to be out, and all three New York area teams in. The Eastern Conference would be 37.5% local in terms of Stanley Cup playoff representation.
Those other teams have their chances.
Well, that's the point. And if you're a Toronto fan, you're thinking about that 4-1 lead you blew against Buffalo a couple of weeks ago, as much as the game that they really didn't show up all that well for against the Islanders on Thursday night. And the Islanders have games they would look at as well. But right now, it's the Leafs who may be looking back in despair. Asham to the front of the net. He wheeled it wide. 4:21 to go. Madden to the Islander line for Pandolfo. Throws one that deflects in. You didn't think it would be simple. Still 4:13 to go, and now it's 2-1, New York.
Took a dirty goal like this to get the Devils on the board. A little breakout's going to get the puck wide, and then the puck's just going to work its way to the front of the net. I think it's a tip coming in, right? Oh, yeah, it is. What a great tip by John Madden. As the puck is brought wide by Pandolfo, he's just looking to shoot the score. John Madden just happens to get his stick on it because he gets himself towards the front of the net. The puck ends up going far side, beating Dublelewicz, and for John Madden, goal number 11.
Well, it gets the Devil fans who are left in the building into it and just applies a little more pressure. 4 minutes to go in the third. The Devils are buzzing. Rupp, or at least Eliash, goes after Hutter. Gomez in there, a 2-on-2. 3:50 and counting. Eliash to the blue line. Oduya shot blocked by Hutter. He went all the way to the blue line to eat that shot. Lit up the boards. Giunta muscles it back to Martin. Now to Gomez, looking for space. Feeds Martin for a drive block. Eliash surrounded by white-shirted Islanders.
A good thing, because Giunta was by himself off the way Dublitz's blocker. Left wing doorstep. If that puck got through, scary situation for the Islanders.
3:16 remaining. Martin's long drive steered into the protective netting by Dublitz.
Well, finally, this big, big crowd here, the last ever regular season game at Continental Airlines Arena, gets going for Lou Lamoriello and the rest of the New Jersey Devils. They didn't have a lot to cheer about, just three shots on goal in the first period. The tie's getting a little tighter around the neck right now for the New York Islanders coaching staff.
You can't loosen it for at least 3:11. That's the time remaining in the third. Lukowicz for Parisi. Langenbrunner just released in time on Polio. He might have gotten a penalty. And Kozlov comes to center. He's by himself, and he's stripped of the puck by Parisi, who muscles it back into the zone. Pody chased by Langenbrunner. Zajac to the boards, throws one in front that's blocked. Zajac has it again. Pody picks it off. And it's sent all the way down. This has enough giddy up for an icing, and as White touches up, they'll bring it back with 2:38. Now let's see if there's a timeout. Ted Nolan has his available.
Anybody watching this game, especially the fans in Canada, can't say that Scott Clementson has been the reason that the New Jersey Devils are trailing in this game. He's faced 24 shots. He's made a lot of good saves. The first one was just willed in by Richard Park, a scramble in front of the net. And the last goal by Park as well, there's a lot of bodies in front of him. The effort of the Devils has been good. Maybe not as good as it would be if they were playing for a little bit something more, but the last 3 minutes, they're playing very hard.
There's no way they could have matched the Islanders' intensity with what's at stake for the Islanders and with nothing at stake for them.
No way. No way.
Now Rafalski with 2:17. Pandolfo in off of Madden. Dublelewicz didn't get enough of that because Breland knocked it down, but now Witt has a chance to clear, and he does. Rafalski in a little trouble here against Smith. And the play breaks down and goes offside. 2 minutes and 3 seconds remaining.
And a lot of time left, though. Ted Nolan is going to try and manage the minutes of the guys he has out there. Certain guys like Ryan Smith, Mike Sillinger, he's going to watch their minutes. He's waited to use his timeout. He needs to keep Hill and Witt as fresh as possible as well. And he'll have Sillinger out there for just about every faceoff.
Ryan Giunta offside. Making his move at the blue line. That drew the play off. And took a few seconds off the clock. 1:59 remaining, and now you're not all that long away from where you wonder when Clementson makes his move. Still at least 45 seconds, you would think. Saw Jeff Tambellini not getting too much ice in this game, but certainly soaking up a whole lot of experience that'll pay off down the road. 1:51 remaining in the third period. Martin for Eliash. Surrounded. Turns it over. Smith clears. Sillinger locked up with Martin. Brendan Witt. First step to the boards. Next, the puck is out. And now Hunter brings it in. Hunter safely curls it around towards Smith. A minute 27 to go in the third. A playoff spot hinges on the final minute and 21 seconds.
Watch Clemenson now.
Gomez in. The shot deflected by Pody. 1:17 remaining in the third.
Oh, I would have thought they maybe would have elected to pull him out there with Gomez having complete control of the puck. Got Clemenson still in the net, though. This little break here also gives Hill and Witt, who went off in favor of Bergeron and Pody, a little bit extra time to rest. And now, I believe it's the Devils that are calling the timeout here. It is the Devils. Lou Lamoriello will use his timeout to get these guys rested up. Gianta, Langenbrunner, Gomez, Eliash, all these guys are out there for a bit. Probably set up a play as well and tail to detailing when they want to do or what they want to do with goaltender Scott Clemenson.
And I got to think that timeout is gold to Ted Nolan and the coaching staff. You get to rest your veteran players now, and you still have your own timeout to use with a minute 17
and
left.
It's exactly what's going to happen. So Sean Hill, Brendan Witt come back on the ice. You got to figure as well that Sillinger and Ryan Smith will come back out. Still a long way to go. A minute 17 is long in hockey terms to have certain guys stay out there that long, but out comes Witt and Hill with the faceoff in their own zone, and Sillinger along with Ryan Smith and Trent Hunter.
Sorry, but if Ted was nervous this morning, what's he feeling right now?
Well, he's so into it right now, he don't have time to think. He's probably not, so to speak, overtly that nervous right now. Focus.
Sillinger has been great on the draws. Clemenson is on the bench. The Devils' net is empty. They have a 6-on-5 advantage. Sillinger has won 19 out of 27 faceoffs in this game. He's going to draw with John Madden. A minute and 17 separate the Islanders from a Stanley Cup playoff spot. Eliash holds it in. Down the boards. Now to Madden. He fires. That's blocked and goes out of play.
Got the look they wanted, though, off the faceoff. And Brendan Witt is the one who blocked that shot, as he does regularly. He seems to be okay, though, smiling about it a little bit. We have seen this hundreds of times this year where Brendan Witt does something to make a difference, and usually the difference involves putting his body in harm's way. It's his fifth block on the afternoon already, but John Madden got the look that he wanted with that good faceoff win to start it.
The Devils control the draw. Eliash to Parisi. To the line, Eliash fires, blocked by Smith. 1 minute remaining in the third period. Gianta behind for Gomez. Busted by Sillinger. And out of the zone. Remember, that Devils net is empty. And now Witt backhands it out of the zone. Eliash with 45 to go. The Devils finally get it into the Islanders' zone. Witt back off the boards, over the line, offside as Gomez brought it in. 36.6 seconds remaining.
All on the line. The guys putting it on the line right now. And Ted Nolan might call a timeout here to rest up these guys so they can stay out more. But blocked shot by Ryan Smith with the puck at the point. So key to this because it does not allow the Devils to get the puck through to the net and get the look that they want. Eliash winds up a little bit more. Two guys went down to block it. Good stuff right there. The high man was Smith. The low man was Hunter. One of the two got it, and that time it was Ryan Smith. Now the timeout being taken. Oh, no, it's a broken stick. Veteran play right here. A veteran play by Ryan Smith. He just showed the linesman that it was broken. I don't care if a splinter was out of it. He showed him it was broken, went and got his team 20 more seconds.
Ted Nolan knows it's always a good idea to keep a couple of termites in your jersey. Smith yanked them out at the right time. 36.6 left, and Brendan Witt clears the zone. Eliash throws it in. Remember, the Devil's net is empty. They have an extra skater. Witt around, 25 left. Langenbrunner to Parisi. Back for Langenbrunner. Lines it up. Blocked again by Smith. And Witt clears the zone. No, he doesn't. Langenbrunner kept it in. Hill got a piece of it. 13 to go. Madden had one deflect to the corner. Down to 10 seconds left. Parisi for Langenbrunner. A sliding block by Smith. 5 seconds remaining. Eliash Eliash across. Langenbrenner centers. Dublelewicz down. They score.
Oh!
The red light and the green light are on. Oh, my goodness. We're going to have a controversy.
Oh, no.
Will it count or not? Ted Nolan's pointing the clock. It says no time. We're going to go upstairs and review it. And they'll break it down frame by frame, tenth of a second by tenth of a second.
Here's your best look. John Madden in front of the net. The scramble. Dublelewicz falls down. He can't get over in the good position he wants. It's going to ramp over him. 1-2, 1-1.
Oh, that's a goal.
Oh, no. Oh, my. Dublelewicz could not get over to his right. I don't know if he stumbled. If he got tripped a little as he was trying to get over, are you kidding me?
Well, the referees, I think, no, there's no review here. They've already called it a goal,
however. Oh, it was clear on the overhead.
It was a clear goal. Oh, man.
Well, right now, Billy, how do you refocus? The difference between this happening in regulation time is they just officially announced the goal. In regulation time, had this happened, or in a Stanley Cup playoff game, I should say, you would have the benefit of an intermission. The Islanders don't have that here. How do you regroup?
5-minute game. That's what you've got right now. You've got a 5-minute game. And all you want to do is put it on the line. As we look one more time at John Madden, just getting the puck over Wade Dublowitz. There was such a battle. The puck was kept in by the Devils with about 14 seconds left at the right point. I believe, if memory serves correct, it was Langenbrunner. He kept it in on the side, and he did the smart thing. Instead of panicking and putting it to the front of the net, what he did, Howie, he put it far side. He got it all the way over. So it forced the whole play to shift from the right wing to the left wing, and that shift, I think that's when Dublowitz is trying to power over, and again, he either fell or he just couldn't get square. That was a key play on that. But how do you get get it going right now? I mean, look, it's simple to say it from up here. You just forget about it because you got a five-minute season right now. That's it.
Let me relate a story from Kevin Lowe in the 1994 Stanley Cup playoffs. Remember the game, of course, when Valeri Zelepukin scored with 7.7 seconds remaining in Game 7 to tie the Rangers and send it to the game which Stéphane Matteau eventually won in double overtime. Kevin Lowe, the great veteran defenseman of the Edmonton Oilers for so many years, then with the Rangers, went into the room, and with his teammates obviously down, he said, "Boys, it's only going to be that much sweeter when we win." And somebody on the Islanders has to have that same approach right now.
You have to have amnesia. You've just got to forget about it. I mean, it's easier said than done, but that you have no other choice. 9/10 of a second remaining. Make a face-off and take a face-off here, and then they'll get set for the overtime.
It's a ceremonial face-off. There will be an overtime, and if that doesn't do it, there will be a shootout. In stunning fashion, the Devils have come back. The cheers you hear are probably louder coming down from Toronto than they are from this building. But the Islanders are still where they want to be.
One of the more remarkable finishes, and I can't really call it a finish because it's not over just yet. We're in a soundproof studio, and I think I heard the yelling from clear across Toronto, the houses, the sports bars. They are alive. Remember, the Islanders have to win the game. A point in overtime is not enough. They have to win outright. And I'm already thinking shootout to decide the playoff spot would be absolutely wild.
Brandon,
what a circus finish.
Brandon with it and off.
Right back to Jersey for OT.
Pandolfo with Madden, Lukowicz with Martin for the devil. And now Foti with a drop for Bergeron. Marc-Andre Bergeron with that big shot can't get through. Kozlov has to defend and does smartly against Madden. And now Foti. The Islanders have had no time to shake it off. And Bergeron checked by Eliash. Now Chetan with the Devils changing. Makes his move, takes the shot, and Clemmensen blockers it away. And Gomez around the Devils' goal. Starts to center with Eliash. Gomez in. Tries to split through, nothing doing. Blake picks it off. Jason Blake. Austin at the line. Eliash looks to see who's with him. Has to wait. Eliash into the zone. Eliash lines it up, shoots Dublelewicz to save. Witt got it to the corner. Now Gomez, turned around by Hill. Eliash feeds the blue line. Rafalski to Martin. He flattens it, but the shot goes off of Smith and out of play. 3:31 remaining in overtime.
One more. NHL on TSN Overtime is brought to you by the Next Generation 2.
For three good blocks. They couldn't get it out, and then it rims around. It gets to the weak side. Ted Nolan was helpless watching that.
Rafalski feeds it high in the slot. Gianta pushes it to the corner. Parisi there. But now Smith with a pass that Sillinger tries to grab. Sillinger on Rafalski. Chips it to Smith. White and Smith turn each other around. Sillinger feeds the blue line. Now Pody curls it behind the net. White hard on Smith. Sillinger to get the puck. Mike Sillinger to Bergeron. Wrists one wide. White trying to maintain position on Smith, and the Devils come out. Two on two, it's Gianta with Parisi. Gianta with a drop to Parisi that Pody busted, and Chatan takes back. 2:45 remaining in overtime. Miro Chatan up to the Devils line. Keeps going with Martin there. Kozlov follows. Kozlov looking for room. Puts it in front. Chatan, a shot. Save made by Clemenson. Now Hill fires. He missed the net. Witt keeps it in. 2:21 to go in overtime. Kozlov for Chatan. Chatan checked by Martin. Martin's got the puck now. And Paul Martin starts ahead. Martin to the Islander line. They're offside with 2:07 remaining in overtime. New York Islanders overtime is brought to you by AIG for insurance, investments, retirement. AIG, the strength to be there. And are we glad you're with us on what has been an emotionally draining afternoon in New Jersey.
Everything going so well for a while for the Islanders. And then you saw desperation. We hadn't seen it. We did not see a mail-it-in game from the Devils through two periods at all. No, they didn't perhaps play as hard, but as Howie and I talked about, nothing really to play for. But we saw a desperate team the last 5 minutes, and they came through, John Madden in particular.
Offside, that puck hopped over Lukowicz's stick with a minute 55 remaining in overtime.
And that's the kind of player that John Madden is. Missed 7 games with a groin injury earlier, has 32 points now on the year. He's considered one of the leaders of this team, and how he recognized an opportunity, took advantage of it.
Braylon wins the draw, and Rafalski backs up. Langenbrunner and Braylon, the New Jersey forwards. Lukowicz brings it in and flings it at Dublelewicz. He'll hold on. And now the faceoff will be in the Islanders zone, and you can bet that Mike Sillinger will take the draw as he hops over the boards.
Yeah, he'll come out. Remember, though, late in the game, the Devils won 2 draws in the offensive zone. That was a catalyst as well to get an opportunity. But Sillinger out there for some redemption. Little tentative play right now from the Islanders. Got to get rid of it.
Gomez won the draw. Martin fires and missed the net. A big carom is pushed towards the line. Smith gloves it down, but Martin got it back. 1:34 to go in overtime. Eliash softly ahead. In comes Gomez. Plays it across. Eliash runs into a wall from Brendan Witt. And now White hustles over but can't get there before it comes out of the zone. A minute 18 left of the third. A steal by Smith. Looking for Sillinger. Sillinger, the shot went wide. Hustling is Hilda. Try and hold it at the line. Did. And now the Islanders changing. Chatan though with a steal. Chatan waits. Kozlov to the slot. Pody at the blue line. Shoots, glove by Clemenson. 58.2 remaining in overtime.
A bad play by Paul Martin after the pressure by Miroslav Chatan. And it was Chatan's pressure, remember, that led to Richard Park's second goal of the game. Almost leads to a golden opportunity for the Islanders here with a minute remaining. He's pressured Martin from behind. But Clemenson again comes out, gets his big body in the way, makes an easy glove save.
Madden and Chatan on the face-off. Pody holds it. That was over the plane of the blue line. Yep. And so offside the call, and they'll have to bring it back down.
A lot of time, but you got to start thinking about shootout potential here. Two goalies. Haven't had a lot of work in the NHL in shootouts. Advantage, who the heck knows?
Fewer.
And to think that a playoff spot's going to come down potentially, in 40 seconds to a shootout.
The Islanders will try and avoid that here with Bergeron bringing it in. Marc-Andre Bergeron goes wide. Bergeron, head up, looks for a play. Now moves down the boards to the slot, surrounded.
Oh, penalty coming up. A hooking call coming up from the back referee.
That'll be against New Jersey as Bergeron drew that penalty by holding that puck. And now, as if we haven't had enough tension today, 30.8 seconds remain, and the Islanders will have the man advantage as Madden, who tied it for the Devils and is a brilliant penalty killer, goes off for a hook at 4:29.
Islanders take a timeout. Remember Ryan Smith breaking his stick to get another one? That saved them from having to take a timeout earlier. Now they can take their timeout here in overtime, get things set up. Danny Flynn drawing a play up right now, but Bergeron, the catalyst to that play, kind of shaking his way to the high slot area. Dangerous play, though, because if he loses that, it's a two-on-one the other way. It ends up being a good play because he gets on the strong side. He gets away from Madden behind him, who reaches in. How much more we can take in the up here in this one?
Well, you saw Sillinger and Smith, two veterans, working on the plan, and Bergeron very much a part of it, told by Smith. Now they're going to work this 4-on-3 for 30 seconds. And look where the faceoff is, too. Players will look right to the high slot. Sillinger draws it back to Bergeron. Across to Pody. Pody lines it up. Pody moves up. He shoots. It went wide. Sillinger grabs it along the boards. Feeds Pody. Smith is in front. Sillinger tees it up, shoots. That's blocked. And Martin clears. Dublelewicz comes way out to push it forward. 12 seconds remaining. Pody to Sillinger. Smith stayed onside. It came out of the zone. 6 seconds remaining. Bergeron to Pody. All he can do is move it to the line. And this season will be determined on a shootout.
I can't believe it. I cannot believe that it's going to come down to this.
Well, it's been an improbable journey, hasn't it? And look at how it's going to end. In a shootout with Wade Dublowitz in goal for the Islanders.
Tired right now. Time to unbutton it.
Scott Clemmensen will be the goaltender for New Jersey. Martin Brodeur will school Clemmensen as much as he can here in short time on the Islanders shooters.
Who's Dublowitz talking to now? He's over there in front of assistant coach Dan Lacroix, talking with Jason Blake. Miro Chetan as well. I don't know if he's getting any heads up or... There he goes. Now he's talking to Kozlov because Kozlov played her, and I think Kozlov's... Well, he's shaking his head no as...
He's saying, I don't know.
You got to laugh right now. I mean, I'm real nervous, you know? I mean, there you go. Now you go to Mike Dunham, you talk about it. That's a veteran right there, folks. A veteran netminder, Mike Dunham, just talking with him. Giving him a little heads up, a little stuff. He played New Jersey a bit, obviously. Knows some of the guys.
What is remarkable, though, about how this will end is that you're a coach. You hire assistants. You draw up a plan before training camp on how you want to play the game. You implement that plan through an 82-game regular season, and you get to an absolutely helpless point. The only thing that's left for a coach now is to determine if you're the home coach here, Lou Lamoriello, do you want to shoot first or second? And who do you send out for the shootout? That's the only coaching left to do.
That's it. Now let's remember, and we talked about how Dublowitz doesn't have much shootout experience. But don't forget, just the other night against the New York Rangers, in a situation where if they didn't win that game, the season's done anyway. So he's been there, maybe not that much. I mean, they do have shootouts in the minors as well. But Dublowitz, he's stone cold. I mean, he is absolutely stone cold, leaning on the bench right now. No problem. This is going to be fun for him. The force be with you, Yoda. May the force be with you. Let's check that lightsaber of his as well, that it's working well.
You can see Clemmensen
smiling.
Look at
him laughing. Yeah.
What's the pressure on him?
What's this all about? Warm and fuzzy. Look at this. having a good time there. The Devil bench has been very relaxed. Marty Brodeur was smiling with Scott Clementson earlier. Lou Lamoriello has been slapping everybody, congratulating them, you know, on a good effort coming back. And the Islander bench, no doubt about it, a little more tense, but not where it matters most, and that's Wade Dublelewicz. Wade Dublelewicz has been cash the whole time.
Boy, it must be nice to know you're in the playoffs and have a loosey-goosey atmosphere and attitude. Chatan, Kozlov, and Smith will face Clemenson. Parise, Gianta, and Breelin will shoot against Dublelewicz.
Oh, my.
The season comes down to a shootout. And here comes Miro. Islanders in the shootout.
Stick side shot. Goaltender Clemenson doesn't commit at all. In fact, doesn't move much. But as Miroslav Chatan comes in, he backs him up just enough. Leans with the right shoulder. Beats him to the blocker.
Parise is 6 out of 13 in shootouts. Zach Parise. Dublelewicz far out. Parise makes his move and hits the top shelf.
Made about three moves. Oh, man.
That's one of his patented moves. Take the snapshot. High slot, kick it, and pick it. That's what he does. Kicks the leg, picks it up top. Nice move.
He won't have to pay for dinner in Toronto anytime soon. Now it's Kozlov, who's 4 for 12. Kozlov going wide. Kozlov right in, he scores!
5-hole. Changes the angle just a bit, gets the goaltender moving. Takes it a little wide. Clemenson's got to move a little bit back. Big 5-hole right there. Gets it right by him.
Brian Gianta for the Devils. Again, Dublelewicz way out. Gianta stopped, an aggressive Dublelewicz got a stick on it. And so Ryan Smith will have an opportunity to shoot the Islanders into the Stanley Cup playoffs.
There's that stick work that Wade Dublelewicz used against the Rangers to be perfect there. A huge save on Gianta.
He came from Edmonton on the 27th of February. And he's trying to send the Islanders to Buffalo. Ryan Smith in on goal. Clemenson stops him. And now the pressure will fall on Wade Dublelewicz.
Instead of going straight away, he changes his angle a bit too. Instead of going 5-hole, he tries going the same spot where Chatan went. This time the goaltender Clemenson gets the blocker down.
Every shot that Wade Dublelewicz has ever seen comes down to this confrontation. Sergei Breelin in on goal. The block's awesome. The New York Islanders are headed to the Stanley Cup playoffs in as dramatic a fashion as you could envision.
And right now, there's no bigger fan of the shootout than the New York Islanders.
Or the Toronto Maple Leafs, I doubt it.
I doubt that.
Well,
oh my, Wade Dublelewicz coming through with another enormous save using the lightsaber right there. Five of his six saves in the shootout in the last week have come with the stick. Starting, leading with the stick, and Dublelewicz does it again. I said it before, I'll say it again. Doobie, doobie, doo, he does it for the Islanders. And watch Ted Nolan, he does the do right there as well. Dances his way to Danny Lacroix and Dan Flynn.
Well, Wade Dublelewicz will join Chico Resch and many others who have become Islander folk heroes.
This was a scene at Wayne Gretzky's in Toronto, the last shot and the last hope for the Toronto Maple Leafs. And with that, the season ends for Toronto and its fans.